that's loosely based on a true event about high school kids who decide to kidnap their classmate. So again, in high school means social hierarchy, so individually we all have our own entitlement issues and insecurities and frustration and teen angst, and lahat yung directed towards the coolest kid in the campus, yung alpha jock. So they decide to kidnap him, na nagkataon ano rin siya, parang anak ng narco politician. So sa minds nila, it's almost like vigilante justice lang naman. So they justify it. And they extort money from the parents. And since they're very, yun nga, ambitious, but at the same time amateurish, ang daming errors sa plan nila, and then it all starts to fail. So you see it as a, like, imagine the first, you know, the first half is almost like a very, you know, barkada, dark comedy. And then later on, when they execute their plan, it becomes sort of a suspense thriller. So it's a blend of both. It's something new, something exciting, something I feel like hasn't been made, at least locally.
Well, ako pa dito yung Alpha Jack, yung si Chuck Santos. How do I relate to the role? I don't really relate to the role because I never was the alpha jock in high school. I was that, you know, that little Asian kid in the back of the class every time. But I know I look white here in this country, but trust me, I look super Asian in UK. But no, it's I'm really looking forward to portraying this alpha jock role because it's a challenge and it's exciting, you know.
Yeah. Po dito sa Dead Kids si Blanco, parang siya po yung leader of the gang. Parang siya yung lumalabas na leader of the gang. Tapos, kalma lang siya, timing lang siya. Doon ako nakaka-relate kasi kalma lang naman ako. Timing lang din ako. At medyo leader din naman ako sa mga kaibigan ko. So, siguro yun po yung similarity sa ni Blanco. At excited po ako dun sa... Basta ang ganda kasi yung script ni Director.
Ako naman po dito si Janina. Medyo may pagkakating love interest kami ni Mark Santa Maria, ayun, si Kelvin. And si Janina, siya yung medyo iba sa kanilang lahat. Siya yung medyo hindi sumusunod dun sa norm ng mga millennials. Parang kumbaga siya yung epitome at dapat sundan ng mga kabataan. Kumbaga, diba direk, tama ba? Tapos, parang ako lang. Charot lang. Parang si Sdejong lang. Parang siya yung pinaka role model. Siya yung pinaka dapat i-look up ng mga teenagers sa panahon ngayon. Kasi siya yung may pinaka parang kumbaga malinis na character. So, yun po.
Malinis.
Parang ako lang talaga.
Ako yung pinaka maloko at pinaka malibog sa barkada. Sa pelikulang to, ako may responsibilidad na magbigay ng comic relief. So, hindi nakakatawa yung pelikula, kasi lamin ko yun. Pero like, ito first role ko na ganito, na ako yung comic relief. So, it's a challenging role for me, pero I'm super excited dahil it's nothing like I've ever done before. Si Paola dito, girlfriend niya si Isa, played by Gabby Padilla. And, ayun. Yeah, that's it.
Ako po dito si si Santa Maria. Isa po sa mga bumarkada na pinakatahimik at pinaka off sa kanilang lahat. Kasi malayo po ako sa kanila. Sobrang ako po, yung character ko po dito si Santa Maria, parang lagi po siyang na-OP sa magkakaibigan. Tapos siya yung laging hinihingan ng tulong, sa school, sa ganyan. And yun. Nakaka-relate ako kay Santa Maria kasi sa istorya nung yung buhay niya, like may ilan ako na-experience doon na sa totoong buhay, like as Kelvin. Kaya mas siguro mabibigyan ko ng justice, pero sana pagpalaing pa para mas mabigyan ko ng justice yung character.
Ako po si Gabby, I'm playing Isa. siya po yung girlfriend ng pinakamaloko at pinakamalibog na member natin. So basically, kami po yung comic relief kasi yung dynamic namin siguro, yung main source of comic relief. And yung character ko, may involvement siya in one of the main like plot points of the film. So yeah, and may spoil.
I'm playing Boy. So in contrast with Khalil's character, which is Paolo, ako yung medyo super serious, very secretive, and siguro I can relate to the character in a way na back in high school kasi si Uy, Filipino-Chinese, so very organized. Pero hindi ako Chinese. Eba eh, chinito lang talaga. I have no Chinese blood, pero I'm pure-blooded Filipino. Yeah, so siguro in a way, back in high school, ganun din ako medyo organized with stuff, active in school. So yeah.
Definitely gonna be a challenge. You know, for me, it's the first time na I'll be working with a ensemble cast. Talagang group, maraming characters in one frame, di ba? You want their banter, their chemistry to feel very real and very authentic. It's challenging for me, especially like I don't really consider myself as a actors director, medyo introverted ako. Dati I'm more dun sa tech side, sa cameras, sa writing. And then now, yun nga, I'm tackling this. But I think it's a good way to start kasi it's something very familiar to me, you know, being a millennial, coming from, well, almost the same generation, a few years apart lang naman kami ng mga actors. So I think it's a good starting off point for me to sort of hone my skills rin and craft as a director. For me, every project, I make sure ibang genre, I make sure I learn something new rin as an artist and storyteller. And yeah, I think it still has elements and themes na you would see in my previous work. Pero this is siguro yung pinaka-modern or pinaka-pop na film ko so far.
Well, first of all, I'm very confident na at least cinematically, iba siya. There are scenes here na I know I've never seen in a local film. Like, there are certain images na you've never seen. It's a combination of different visuals na parang nai-imagine ko trailer shot pa lang ng visual na yun. Ang intriguing kasi parang, ano yun? Ano nangyari sa scene na yun? Ba't ang absurd ng image na yun? At the same time, the story is not your usual story. It's a blend of different genres. And then siguro yung third selling point namin is we're packaging it with the potential to sell it outside din. So parang it's very intentional or deliberate na the way we make the film, we want to export it. Maybe even aim for a international world premiere, like what we do with most of my films before we bring it back home. And then hopefully sell it na to international streaming sites and distributed outside. Birdshot was well distributed outside. Neo Manila has been selling outside and even getting like Blu-ray releases. Eerie, I think it's gonna be one of the first na parang regional release. So as nagtitheatrical siya dito, nagtitheatrical siya outside. Not just targeting, you know, Filipino audience outside, but targeting an international audience. And we're hoping to do the same with this. So yeah, we're gonna use the same strategy.